miracle redemptrix of the world. Just as sin entered the world by a woman, and all human beings inherit his original sin and disgrace, even so, God deigned to compensate for our iniquity, giving us another woman and mother, totally different from the first, opposed to the sinful nature of Eve, to be the mother of grace and victorious over evil. It is difficult for many Catholics, and even more for Protestants, to understand the mediation of Mary and her cooperation in the work of salvation. As a consequence of the fall of man by the sin of Eve, God in his justice ruled that man was to be expelled from paradise, and that in his disgrace he returned to the dust where he had been formed. Genesis chapter 3, verse 19. Right then, God also cursed the serpent, or Satan, for having tempted the woman. Then God predicted enmity between Satan and the woman, and between his offspring and hers. Then God said that the woman's offspring will crush Satan's head, although he will strike the heel of the woman. God foretells the spiritual struggle for salvation, in which we need Jesus and Mary. The first announcement of salvation, also called the Proto-Evangelium, is given to Adam and Eve in the presence of the serpent. God is not speaking about Eve, because she made herself unworthy by her sin. Let's see how God is talking about a new woman, an immaculate woman, sinless, full of grace, whose son will crush Satan's head. This woman is the Blessed Virgin Mary, without sin, who not only conceived in her womb the Son of God, the Redeemer of the world, but also conceives all the children of God in the new order of grace, the new creation, where human beings are not procreated, but God creates in grace, where the children are not born of the desires of the flesh and lust as human beings, but we are born in the grace of God, children of God, our Father, and Mary, our Heavenly Mother, the new Eve. We are divine children conceived by the power that Christ gives to those who believe in him. John chapter 1, verses 12 to 13. But to all who received the word of God, who became flesh, Jesus gave power to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not of blood, not of the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but were born of God. The first humanity or creation generated in paradise is our humanity, which is totally lost if we do not accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Redeemer. Jesus tells us that we must be born again to enter the kingdom of heaven. John 3, verse 3. Being born again is precisely entering the body of Christ, first in baptism, since it is the only way to the Father. In baptism, we are immersed in the water of grace. We are clothed with the light of Christ. We enter Christ, our eternal Father, to be his children. And we also enter the immaculate spiritual womb of Mary to become children of Mary. God's word tells us in Matthew chapter 6, verse 10, on earth as it is in heaven. On earth, as human beings, we need a father and a mother. In the order of grace, as God's children, we need a father and a mother. Jesus is the new Adam and Mary is the new Eve. When we talk about Christ, we talk about the new man in the new creation, a man containing the union of the Spirit of God with human nature, true God, and true man. This is why Scripture tells us that there is only one mediator between God and men, Christ Jesus. 1 Timothy chapter 2, verses 5 to 6, "For there is one God and one mediator between God and men, Christ Jesus, himself human, who gave himself as a ransom for all." Christ Jesus represents this new creation of grace, which we have mentioned, in which our human nature is mixed with the divine nature, taking part of this precious blood that Christ offers us in his redemption to purify our souls from sin and thus receive salvation. So far, we all point to Christ as the one mediator between God and men. But let us see who Christ is. Jesus Christ died on the cross, but continues being alive in his church. So we say that the church is the body of Christ. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 27, "Now you are the body of Christ, and members, each in their own way." When we pray, our prayer as human beings is raised in the Spirit and comes to the Spirit of God in Christ. God does not hear the human being without the action of Christ his Son. And Jesus, in John chapter 14, verse 6, tells us, "No one can come to the Father but through me, since I am the way, the truth, and the life." God shows us how necessary is this union of the Spirit and the flesh in Christ Jesus to hear our prayer through Christ crucified, because that is the way we achieve our redemption. Mary, co-redemptrix of the world. What is her role? Why do we call her co-redemptrix? Mary was the most holy of all saints. As first fruits of the new creation in grace, God granted her the unique privilege of being born without the guilt of original sin, since before the creation of the angels and human beings, he consecrated her to be his own beloved mother, his beloved daughter, and his beloved spouse, in whom God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit found their complacency. The Church has accepted Mary with different titles that have become dogmas. First, as Mother of God, since Jesus is God. Second, as Immaculate Conception, the perfect work of God. Third, as Virgin Mother, virgin before, during, and after the birth of Jesus. Fourth, as Our Lady, assumed body and soul to heaven. Since she had no sin, she did not have to return to the dust in the curse of paradise. Mary, co-redemptrix of the world and the Church. The title of Mary as co-redemptrix of the world has been proposed to the Church based on revelations of the Virgin Mary herself, as was given to Sister Mary of Agreda in the book The Mystical City of God, and as proposed by the Blessed Virgin Mary in apparitions to Ida Pierdeman, a seer in Holland. Our Lady asked to be called Lady of All Nations, Co-Redemptrix, Mediatrix of Grace, and Advocate of Men. And why is Mary Co-Redemptrix? The work of salvation was accomplished by the new Eve and the new Adam. Since the beginning of man, God announced Mary as the woman, the new Eve, the mother of his Son. In the New Testament, God visits her and calls her full of grace. She begins the work of salvation with her fiat, in which she accepts the union of the divine nature with human nature in her womb, so that the redemption of humanity is accomplished. Humanity is redeemed by the blood of the Lamb of God, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The Blessed Virgin Mary sheared her body in blood, clothed the Spirit of the Word of God with her humanity. In this union between God and man, so for this reason, she is also co-redemptrix. The blood that we drink for our salvation is the blood of Jesus, which comes directly from the Immaculate Blood of Mary, since she did not sin and conceived Jesus by the grace of the Holy Spirit. Mary participated in all the sufferings for the salvation of humanity. From birth, she prayed for the redemption of the world. She clamored the coming of the Redeemer, without even knowing that she would be his own mother. She accompanied Jesus in all his sufferings, from his childhood, and was united with him in his soul, participating in his passion, agony, and death. Her first tears were mixed with the blood of Jesus in the circumcision. Then she shed tears during the prophecy of Simeon. She suffered during the flight into Egypt and wept for the innocent killed in whom Herod sought to kill Jesus. She cried for 3 days when the child Jesus was lost, when he was in the temple of Jerusalem. She also suffered with the death of Saint Joseph. Later on, when Jesus went into the wilderness for 40 days, she suffered during the ministry of Jesus because of the hatred of the Pharisees against Jesus. She participated in the passion of our Lord, suffered when he was arrested, when he was tied up, beaten, insulted, spat upon, scourged, when he was crowned with thorns, was tried and condemned to death, when they made him carry that heavy cross that made him suffer so much. He also suffered in his folds, then he was stripped violently, tearing his skin. Afterwards, they crucified him. There, she accompanied him during those long 3 hours of agony. Then he suffered a lot of pain and finally died. Then they pierced his heart by the lance. Then she received his lifeless body in her arms and left him in the tomb, bathed with her tears. All the sufferings of the Virgin Mary continued until the resurrection. She continues to suffer for every soul, since she is our mother. All this that our Blessed Virgin Mary did is her participation in our salvation as co-redemptrix. She is called the Mother of Faith. Abraham was justified and called the Father of the Faith for offering his son Isaac as a sacrifice to the Lord, although it did not eventuate, as the angel of the Lord stopped him. But Mary, Mother of Faith, by her faith and her works, offered her son to the Eternal Father for the forgiveness of the sins of all mankind. She participated in the new priesthood of the holy people of God, who offers the sacrifice of Christ to God for the forgiveness of sins. The Blessed Virgin Mary is co-redemptrix of humanity. She is totally united to Christ. Let us look again at the Word of God in Matthew chapter 6, verse 10, on earth as it is in heaven, and in Mark chapter 10, verse 8, and a man will join a woman, and the two shall become one flesh, Jesus and Mary. God the Spirit joined Mary to form a new creation in grace. So Mary is united to God in such a way that, being a creature, she enjoys the divine nature. Jesus made this prayer to the Father in John chapter 17, verse 21, that they all may be one. As you, Father, are in me and I in you, may they also be one in us, so that the world believe that you have sent me. When we pray with Mary, we are praying with Jesus, for Jesus is not separated from Mary. And when we pray to Jesus, we are praying to Mary, because Mary is not separated from Jesus. They are one. May the Spirit of God enlighten you. Mary has been clothed in light, majesty, and glory. She has been lifted up from the dust to the throne of God. She has been appointed by God as Lady, Queen, and Mother of God the Son. And as the new Eve, Mother of all the children of God in grace. She has received the participation of the divine attributes of power, wisdom, divine love, grace, divine will, omnipotence, omnipresence, omniscience, peace, mercy, and the joy of living in God's presence, and many more beautiful things in the Spirit, which are impossible to imagine in our human capacity. O Mary, co-redemptrix of the world, mediatrix of grace, our advocate, pray for us. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to Thee. If you like this video, please give us a like, please subscribe to our channel, and please share this reflection of Our Lady to the whole world. And please leave your comments. God bless you.